Well, thank you, Frode. I'm just waiting for my presentation. Dear colleagues, first of all, I'd also like to congratulate Baltic State Technical University and Norwegian-Russian on 25 years of cooperation. Long may it continue. Visions for the future require an understanding of the present, and what I'm going to try to do is give you a brief overview of cooperation between Norway and Russia in higher education and research today. There will be speakers later who will give you more details, so this will just be a snapshot. And I would like to start, while we wait for my presentation to come up, by focusing on the institutions, the universities and research institutes that form the core and the key to cooperation. I think that, of course, individual students may decide to go and study in another country on their own initiative, or researchers may team up to carry out projects together, but in order to achieve sustainable long-term cooperation, it needs to be anchored or rooted at the institutional level, and by institutional level, I ultimately mean decisions by the board. It has to be part of the strategy of each institution. There has to be a commitment on both sides. There has to be a will to work together over time and build trust as a basis for commitment and as a basis for developing things together. And I think, of course, we're witnessing a prime example of this today in the cooperation between Baltic State Technical University and Norwegian-Russian. Have been patiently developing, patiently and successfully, I should say, developing their cooperation over the past 25 years. When cooperation is based at the institutional level, as I said, you can have research cooperation which is based in institutional strategies. When you send your students to the other university, you know what they'll get. And also, this makes it possible to link cooperation in higher education and cooperation in research in a way that is otherwise not so easy to achieve. And this is something that we emphasize very strongly from the side of the, from the part of the Norwegian authorities, that it's a great advantage if we can have cooperation both in education and research at the same time. Now, okay. I represent the ministry, and what the authorities can do is, of course, to facilitate institutional cooperation in various ways. You need national legislation which is favorable to international cooperation in higher education and research. You need agreements, not just at the national level, but also at the regional level, as was mentioned by Mr. Maximov, among others. And in the case of Norway and Russia, we have a memorandum of understanding from 2010 in cooperation in higher education. And we also have, or we almost have, an agreement on cooperation in research and technology, which has been, which we have been in the process of negotiating for a long time, which is, I think, ready to be signed quite soon. Also, of course, the governments are an important source of income. In Norway, the universities receive a substantial share of their budgets directly from the government. But the government also finances programs where institutions compete for resources, mainly through the Research Council of Norway and the Norwegian Center for Cooperation for international cooperation in education. You will hear representatives from these organizations later on. They are the agents who put national policies into practice. They are the people working in the field and supporting the universities, the higher education institutions, in their efforts to build sustainable partnerships. And of course, there are also agencies on the Russian side. There's, for instance, Rasatrunishstvo, which makes a part in student exchange programs. There are foundations financing research, joint research projects with the Research Council of Norway, and so on. Now, although we're here to celebrate the cooperation between Baltic State Technical University and Norwegian-Russian, I'd like to mention that there are, in fact, other players in the field, and in terms of research cooperation, the cooperation between the Norwegian Institute of Maritime Research and PINRO in Murmansk actually goes further back and has been very successful in assessing fish stocks in the Barents Sea as a basis for determining quotas. And this cooperation goes on. There are lots of research institutes on both sides involved in cooperation. There are lots of universities. Some are more active than others, it's true. In Norway, in addition to Norwegian-Russian, both the University of Tromsø and the University of Oslo have defined Russia as a strategic partner country, and they have strategic partners at the university level as well. And I'd like to mention, since we're in St. Petersburg in particular, that the University of Oslo has a very big project in medicine, together with the Almasov Institute, which was mentioned, and Pavlov University and Mexico University. Okay? See if we can. Yeah, thank you. Yes, it's good that we got the slides, because otherwise I would have forgotten to mention the Panorama strategy, which is a strategy published by the Norwegian government last year, where it identified a number of strategic partner countries in higher education. One of them is Russia. As you know, Norway is a small country, we can't cooperate with everyone, so we've chosen a relatively small number of countries as strategic partners, and Russia is one of them for many reasons, because of our neighboring countries, of course. For instance, we have a long history of cooperating, and of course Russia has many excellent research groups and higher education institutions. So the strategy defines priorities, lays down principles, and sets goals, and also is backed by financing to show that we mean it. We actually put up money to support cooperation with Russia in higher education and research. I think you'll hear more about this later. And increasingly, these programs are geared towards the institutional level for reasons which I've already described. Now here you see some examples of both Norwegian and Russian institutions that are involved in cooperation projects. I could mention many more. In St. Petersburg, for instance, it's not just the State University, it's not just Weidenbech, but I could mention ITMO, I could mention the Mining University, I could mention the Polytechnic University, I could mention Bergsen University, and so on. And it's the same. These are just some of the main, some of the most active institutions in Norwegian-Russian cooperation. Now, in research, there's a lot of cooperation which is centered on the Arctic, not surprisingly, after hearing Eric Sivertsen. There's a lot of marine research, but also there are projects in other fields, and I would especially like to mention history, where a two-volume history of the last 200 years of Norwegian-Russian relations was published last year, or the first volume, I think, was published 2 years ago, and then the second volume last year. And the remarkable thing is that these books have been jointly written by Norwegian and Russian historians, meaning that it's one text which everyone has agreed on. It's not a collection of papers, it's one text which both Norwegian and Russian historians have put their names to. Student exchange. I totally agree with Eirik Sivertsen and other speakers on the importance of student exchange. We have quite a large number of Russian students in Norway. This has been the situation for many years now. Not so many Norwegian students in Russia, but we're working on it. One thing which we tried this year, and which I think, well, I both hope and believe will lead to good results, is that we sent about 30 Norwegian students on summer courses with a stipend to various Russian partner institutions, to the institutions that we try to prioritize in our cooperative efforts. And of course, the hope is that they will come back later for more extensive stays. Now, the High School of Economics recently published, the High School of Economics in Moscow, that is, recently published a report as a basis for future Russian research priorities. And in this report, countries were ranked, and this is on the basis of so-called bibliometric indicators, that is, publications and citations. Norway was ranked as number 12 in importance as a research partner for Russian scientists today. But the interesting thing was that when the same scientists and experts were asked about the future, Norway comes higher on the list and was in fact number 5, ranked as number 5 when it comes to potential for research cooperation. Also, different fields were mentioned, and in addition to the fields that I showed you, aquaculture was given special mention as a very promising field for cooperation. And of course, we very much like research cooperation between Norway and Russia to develop in such a way that we will climb in the tables. Also, we would like to get more Norwegian students to go to Russia, as I mentioned. The question, of course, is how we get there. And I already indicated what I think is at least part of the answer. We have to stimulate and support our higher education and research institutions in their efforts to establish sustainable cooperative relationships. And again, I think Norwegian-Russian and Baltic State Technical University have shown the way. Others are following. For instance, there are now other Norwegian and Russian universities that have established joint programs. Baltic State and the Norwegian University were the first, but others are following. And my hope is that with support from relevant programs at the government level, with backing from regional authorities, with the involvement of business and industry, this will lead to further successes. Thank you very much.